Let's now proceed with the eighth example, which is all about the integral of 1 over the cube root of x raised to 5. So, this can be written as, So, this can be written as 1 over x raised to 5/3 dx. But again, wala tayong direct formula on how to deal with this. So, what you do is you write this again, remove the integral of x raised to negative 5/3 dx. Okay? So, let us now evaluate this since we have a direct formula for this. So, here we have x raised to negative 5/3 plus 1 over negative 5/3 plus 1 plus 0. So, let us evaluate this. So, this becomes x raised to, what is negative 5/3 plus 1? Okay, we have negative 2/3. So, over negative 2/3. So, ayusin natin yung 3 na. And then, we have plus 0. Okay, let us evaluate, evaluate this further, so this becomes x raised to negative 2/3, okay, over, by the way, negative 2/3, kaya natin i-simplify yan into this one. Okay, negative 3x to the negative 2/3 over 2, and then plus equals. Pwede yan. Let's now proceed with the final example, which is the integral of x squared plus 3x plus 2 times x minus 1 dx. But in our antiderivative or integral formulas, we don't have any direct formula or rules that will cater this scenario in item number 9, which is the product of factors. So what will you do with this? In order for you to apply directly the antiderivative or integral formulas that you have. So all you have to do is to just simply get the product of these factors. So let us use this equation. So in this case, so this can be written as x cubed plus 3x squared. Okay, plus 2x, then here we have minus x squared, then we have minus 3x, then we have minus 2 dx. Combine like terms and pass it on. So this becomes the integral of x cubed, then 3x squared minus x squared is positive 2x squared, and then 2x minus 3x is negative x, and then minus 2 dx. Alright? Then, let us now apply directly the antiderivative or integral formulas. So in this case, we have the integral of x cubed dx, and then plus the integral of 2x squared dx, okay? And then minus the integral of x dx, and then minus the integral of 2 dx. So, this becomes, what? The integral of x cubed dx. Then we have plus, ilalabas natin yung constants, integral symbol. So, 2 times the integral of x squared dx. And then minus the integral of x dx. And then minus 2, the integral of dx. Alright? So let us now evaluate this. Tatanggal natin yung integral symbol at si dx. So this becomes x to the 4th over 4. And then plus 2 x cubed over 3. And then minus x squared over 2. And then minus 2x plus 3. So we simplify this further. So this becomes x to the 4th over 4. And then plus 2x cubed over 3. function in item number 9. For example, number 9. By the way, STEM students, thank you very much for watching this video, and I hope that you will be able to learn this lesson, particularly the antiderivatives.